Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Stories Art and Craft. I hope you all are doing well. So in this video I have created a 3D cone net using glitter paper. So I have created the 3D cone net earlier also but with paper, and it was liked by many of you. Thank you so much for that. But I received some messages that few people were not able to understand how it was made. So this time I thought of trying it with a glitter paper. So let's see how it works. Now here, as a radius of a circle, I have taken 5 cm as radius. So we will be drawing a circle of radius 5 cm here, and which will make the diameter 10 cm obviously. And after that we will decide upon how to draw the line above for the cone area. Now here I have drawn the circle with diameter 10 cm. So let's draw the diameter here first, and then we have to draw one more line just above the diameter. And first I took it 10 cm, but it didn't work well. Just see why. So as I started making the curve from the other point, it was not covering the whole page, and according to me, it was not good enough to make a proper 3D cone. So that's why I just added 2 more centimeters to that. That means it was now 12 cm, and again I just drew the curve again. And this time it covered the whole page. It touched the page from both sides, and then I was able to join the points of the curve with the middle line. And next step we have to follow is to just cut the shape which we have drawn, that is the curve along with the circle. And now we have to mark some points to make holes in the shape so that we can pass through the thread, and we can use the thread to make create our 3D net. So here I just made one hole in the circle at the bottom, middle bottom, and then I used almost 5 holes each side. But what I did was I just kept the upper 2 holes at same place, I mean at the same level, but the holes at left side and right side of this shape, they were not at equal level. They were just a little up down from each other, because that what I felt was necessary to, you know, close the cone shape properly. So now it's time to use the thread to create the 3D shape. And here I have used a wool because it's soft enough, and I think that it will not cut the glitter sheet while pulling. And if you see that at the top, I just put a knot here because we will only need one side of the thread at the bottom. And in this, if you see, I just followed the process of inside out from one side, from left side, and outside in from the right side. So If you see carefully, you will be able to know that how I am using the thread to pass through the shape. From the left side, I just used inside out, and from right side it was outside in. And this way we will pass the thread through all the holes. Okay, so now it's time to see if it works or not. So we need to pull the thread slowly, and you can see that the cone is coming into shape slowly, but with me it's stuck at one point at the bottom. So I had to pull the thread from top to bottom to fix it in the proper shape. But at last it came out good according to me, and what I feel is this is one way which I thought of, but there may be many other ways to create this 3D cone net. So if you experiment any other way, or if you know about any other way how to create this, so I would love to learn that. So I request you to share it in the comment box. And so here the 3D cone net is ready, which has been created using the A4 size glitter sheet, and I have tested it again by pasting it on a paper. So I just glued it on a white A4 paper, so that if we need to present it somewhere, we can just write the measurements or the name of the shape. Or maybe if you have to make it more beautiful or decorative, etc. So here again you can see that the shape is coming out slowly, but it worked. So I hope you like this video. Thank you for watching, and do share this video if you like it. It may be of help to other people. And if you have any suggestions, or if you need some more help, so you can just write in the comment box, and I'll try to create more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching this, and maybe we'll meet again in another video. Till then, bye bye.